Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. Good afternoon. As mentioned by Brother Noel, I'm Brother Allaine Sotto. Just a disclaimer, as I always say when I start giving talk, I am not related to the Sotos. Just to clear things out. But yes, we're both good looking, definitely. That is one trait that I will not say no. Right? So we are actually at the last, at the tail end of our session. Have you not noticed that time passed by and you did not realize that this long you have been journeying with us? Correct? I know some have missed one, some did not miss any talk. Some really completed the talk from start until now. And that, if you will think of, is something that you will not say will happen to you. Have you ever thought of sitting here for how many sessions, listening, that it's already at the end? It is always an ending, but a start of a new beginning. No, this is not the end, and this is, will not be the end of us seeing each other. So, we are now in talk number 12, Transformation in Christ. But let me introduce to you my family. Of course, my wife is there, si Sky. She is the most beautiful woman in my eyes, of course. In your higher spouses, of course, you have your own preference. She's the most beautiful, next to none sa ladies. And here's my family. We have Angelo, he's 16, the one holding 20 because we're already 20 years married. We are 19 years in the community. And we have Catherine, our only girl, Emmanuel, and the Rams, the youngest. So I have 16, 8, 5, and 3. We're a big family. When you try to consider here in Singapore, it's a big family. But it's just a small family because I came from a family of 7 children. So it's just a middle for us. So let us now proceed to the transformation in Christ talk. If you are to look and compare our journey, it's like a butterfly. From a caterpillar, turning into a cocoon, and then turning to a full butterfly. It went into stages. Right? We never thought that these stages will carry us out up to this moment. And we really did not realize, if we are to look back, something has changed in our lives. Something has changed between the spouse and the way they talk with each other. Something has changed when it comes to the handmaids, when they try to think of the issues that they have and the challenges that they have at work and the relationship with their families back home. That is all because of the grace of God. So we will try to look back and let's process everything. And what else can we do with this journey? What has stored for us from God will be revealed. It will just be a short discussion and talk. But we will try to further deepen our understanding in what should we go next. What's our next level? So, we started with talk number 1, 2, 3, and 4, which is known to be the basic truth about Christianity. We know that God's love, He loves us, and because of that love, He sent Jesus, His only Son, to save us. Knowing Jesus, we become His follower. That's why we are called Christian. It was even mentioned that if you will remove Christ, in the East Christian, the word you will be, I am nothing. We are nothing without Christ. And of course, we understood. Now, in order for us to progress in our faith, we have to repent, remove our old self, and become a new creation. That's why we need to repent and we have faith. Because that faith will carry us in our journey when it comes to our Christian life. Next, from the caterpillar, we become a cocoon. The module 2 gives us the ideal of what is the authentic life of being a Christian. Talk number 5 gives loving God. What's the ideal? Our ideal is to love God with all our heart, mind, and strength. It's everything that we have. And then, of course, after loving God, we should now love our neighbor. And we have been asked, who is our neighbor? We have been answered that whoever is in need is our neighbor. Whoever is in need is our neighbor. That is giving us the example of the Good Samaritan, right? From which the Samaritan, an outcast of the society, has helped that fellow that has been robbed, had been hurt, even giving his money to make sure the welfare of that person has been addressed. And that is us now, brothers and sisters. And realize, you know, that we are family. But we need to be not only family, we need to be Christian family. Putting Christ in the center of our relationship. Sideline, for me and my wife, we are so blessed because we started our married life in the right path. Because after getting married, we become immediately members of Couples for Christ. That's why 19 years. Imagine 19 years of hardship, no? My wife having from me. If we are not in the Couples for Christ community, we might not be a couple anymore. But because we put Christ in the center of our life, everything and anything that comes our way can be addressed because of that faith. We never quarrel. We quarrel, of course. But she cannot even throw a plate on me anymore because Christ is in the center. So if she throws something, Christ will be hit. And as I mentioned, as I always say, I understood in a startup relationship, you should not have any glassware. All by plastic. So it's more economical. Because no, I'm just trying to lighten up because this is a very wee hour, no? It's a very critical time for us. No, we might fall asleep. And then of course we need to understand our life in the Holy Spirit. There's a lot of gifts that's available for us. We just need to claim it. We need to use it. And now on the last stage, as we are now a full butterfly, we have received the power of the Holy Spirit that was with us and is still in us when we were baptized, confirmed, reaffirmed when we got married. Now, for those who are married, no, it's there. We just need to call upon the Holy Spirit to help us. And not only that, we have been given tools on how we will grow. No, there are 5 tools that will allow us: prayer, scripture, fellowship, sacrament, service. And that will allow us and will propel our faith into a next level because we are now serving. We are now being servants of the Lord. We are being in service to others. And now we are into this last stage. After we've learned last week, the life and mission of Couples for Christ is a transformation in Christ. Now you need to allow the Lord to continue the process of your transformation. This is a process. It never stops. Our faith progresses, deepens our relationship with Christ as a couple, as an individual, will further go deeper because of our continuous transformation for the better. Remember, brothers and sisters, that the devil is always lurking around. Sometimes, the more you go nearer to God, the more that he will double up his effort to destroy you. It is not for the purpose of just destroying your relationship. It's because he wants you to be part of his dominion. That's why we should not stop from here. We should journey. The more we need to journey now because he is not happy. Because he have lost another member. Because now we are in the path to holiness. This is our main aim. We are not just here to amass the wealth of this world. But remember, we are trying to amass the wealth in heaven. The Holy Spirit is at work so that you can grow in reference to God. We will know Him more. Our knowledge is still limited. No, there's so much more to learn about God. We need to know more how to love Him more. Through what actions, through what things that we need to do. It is not just praying. We need to do other things to show how we should love God. And lastly, because of that love, we will serve Him. We will serve Him more. You have seen our brothers and sisters here, the service team. You have seen the smile in their faces. And that is the service love that they are giving to us when we're doing the CLP. You ask them to do it again tomorrow, they will do it. Yes?
Amen.
Oh, we have a possible team leader here already. Yeah. That resounding yes is really reverberating here. So, meaning, once you have... pinipingot na tuloy. Once you have journeyed in faith, you should not worry because you are not journeying alone. You have a community that will go with you and will travel, go in any place, anywhere because you are doing service to God. We are missionaries, my wife and I. I've been to Mongolia, I've been to India, I've been to the best place where biryani chicken is there, Hyderabad. Triple X level of spiciness. God has brought me to that place because of that service love. Should I be fearful? No. Should I get worried when I leave my family behind? No. Because I know that they are in the hands of the Lord and I'm doing God's work. That is a transformation that will also happen to you. And we will all journey together, brothers and sisters. But let us try to take a concrete example in a Bible story from which God used or we can use in this transformation. There is a story in the Bible about the blind man. It is in John 9, verse 138. We know that we have heard and we have read so many stories that Jesus actually just cured people without anything. He just touched the hands, lay the hands of that to that fellow, and he got cured or she got cured. But this story is different. This story went into a process. This blind man has been blind since birth. So he was not able to see the world since birth. Nothing. It's total darkness. But his desire is to be able to see. So hearing that there's someone that can do this, he begged for mercy and say, please, I want to see. Jesus took a mud, spit on it, and then splat it into the eyes of this blind person and asked him to go wash it into the river. So then he did go. After that, of course, he was able to see. He was rejoicing and people saw him and then say, is he not the blind man? How come he is able to see now? And he was asked, who did this to you? He just said, a man called Jesus, not knowing him. A total unfamiliarity. He is someone just called Jesus. And then, the Pharisees are really hot at the end of Jesus, at the tail of Jesus, because they want to find a way how to persecute him, they called up this blind person. Who healed you? Then he answered, man called Jesus, and he is a prophet. Now the recognition is there. They even called the parents of the blind person. Is he not your son? Is he really blind since birth? What did the parents said? You ask him. He's already old enough to answer your question. And at the last stage, his personal encounter with Jesus, he was able to recognize who healed you. Lord, I believe you're my God. He had recognized. And this is what happened to us. From someone knowing Jesus, just saying Jesus, we realize now that Jesus is not only a prophet, He is also our Savior and our God. This is very normal to our conversion. Even as we are Catholic, we are being re-evangelized because things that we don't know are now being revealed before us. Now, continuing on the transformation, we should grow in holiness. Holiness because have you not asked yourself, why are you here? what is that desire in your heart that had led you to this place? Why is it someone that spoke to you about Christian Life Program, you have responded? Or better yet, you already know this community and then you have looked for it again because of that desire to holiness. This is not by accident, brothers and sisters. Total strangers knowing each other now because of faith. Because by design, God is always knocking at our doorstep. He is just waiting for us to open our hearts and our mind. Let's grow in discipleship. We have our own crosses to carry, but we will journey together as a family. We will grow in discipleship by learning together as one community. And of course, greater commitment to service. We will now understand that our service is not only limited amongst ourselves. We should serve the church, we should serve the community, and we should even serve our country. Because we will have that greater commitment to service. And this is what had led us to become missionaries. We are so-called volunteers, no? We are not being paid for, but we are doing it because this is God's work. The work of God is needed to be spread out. I've been in Myanmar, Indonesia. I went to Mongolia, but when I went to Mongolia, there's no snow. So I need to go back again because I want to see the snow there. Because they say the snow there is whiter than the normal snow in Korea. I think you have to go to Mongolia as well. Huh? So we need to grow in holiness. Be, as mentioned in 1 Peter 1:15 to 16, be holy in all that you do, just as God who called you is holy. The scripture says, be holy because I am holy. Our aim is path to holiness because we emulate this from Christ because Christ is holy. Our aim is our investment after life. We want to go to heaven, right? You want to go to heaven now? Oh, I know you will not say answer. I know you will not answer yet, no? I will give you time to think. No, but our aim is always to be ready because we don't know what happens next. But how prepared are we now that we have been it has been revealed to us? How prepared are we? Because every morning that we will wake up, we open up our eyes. It's a blessing already. Because once we close our eyes, there is no certainty in life. Amen?
Amen.
So let us journey together through that path of holiness. As I mentioned, grow in discipleship. If anyone wishes to come after me, you must deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. No. It is not a bed of roses. Starting your journey through faithfulness, you will be tried because you will be tried by the devil. God will not desire heartaches and hardship in your life. But we need to be steadfast. Because what we do and how we do things will allow others to be inspired as well. By just merely looking at you couples or just looking at you handmaids of the Lord, your aura, no, your facial expression, the way you talk, will be able to magnetize people and ask you, what happened? Something had changed. That is because God has been working in your lives. You will not notice this, brothers especially, that every time you face yourself and look at the mirror, you will look that you're getting good look, better and better and better. Your good looks is, you know, becoming very evident. No? So just always face the mirror. You know, try to see the changes. Sisters, I said brothers only. I'm just kidding. Meaning, we become beautiful not only in the eyes of God, but in the eyes of the world. Because that is His intention, brothers and sisters. There will be a lot of hardship, but every hardship will be easy because we journey with God who is carrying us through those hardships. And last, of course, grow in greater commitment in service. Each of you should use whatever gift you have received to serve others as faithful stewards of God's grace in its various forms. We have different gifts. You know, talent in music, art, craft. You have gifts in how to speak. Let us use this in service in the church. Remember, one of our in our mission and vision, no? One with the Catholic Church. No? We work together hand in hand. Church need workers. We as a community will help. If they need lectors, we can serve. If you are going to OLSS, you will see most of the servants there are members of Corpus for Christ. If you go to St. Anthony where I serve, most of the Eucharistic ministers and stewards there are members of Corpus for Christ. Because we serve in whatever capacity that God needs us. We do not enclose that talent and shelve it because it's made for us to be used. As I mentioned, we are raising up families in the Holy Spirit that will renew the face of the earth. Not only we, but including our family. In Talk 11, you know, it has been discussed, the ministries of Couples for Christ. Later on, we will give you some pictures of what we do, what are the things that can be done for us to grow together. Remember that we are called because of the fulfillments of God's plan and because of the Great Commission. It is said in Matthew 28, you know, verse 18 to 20. You know, go forth and baptize them under the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. You know, becoming them, you will empower them, discipleship. Because that is what is needed. We are commissioned to baptize them. We, the evangelized, will become the evangelizers. It is a great privilege to be where we are now. Not everybody that had been called has stayed that long to be here. Some still have their own preferences. Some still not opening up themselves through the calling of God. But you, brothers and sisters, are already here. And we are privileged to be part of that journey together with you. Because this is just a beginning, brothers and sisters. So how are we going to grow in the community? Having a personal relationship with Jesus and being a vibrant community such as CFC and the family ministry. Have you not noticed your prayer time become better? Longer? Now, we read scriptures. Last time, you just swipe it up and someone send you verses. Now, we try to really talk to God. It is not just by asking blessings, but just asking Him guidance. Asking Him, how should I go by this day? Mother Mary, please pray for me because I am really in trouble. I feel down. But because of that transformation, no, our personal relationship with Jesus had improved. This has happened through no work of your own, but simply by God's mercy and grace. Remember, He loved us first. And even if we don't love Him, He will never stop loving us. That is how God's persistence when it comes to love. He had sent His Son because of love. Jesus died because of that love. And until now, that love exists to be shared among us as the children of God. And we ought to respond with gratitude and humility. What else should be our postures, brothers and sisters? No? We should be thankful because there is a loving God that is still reaching His hands, even we are sinful. There is a loving God that is still persistently calling us by name, each and every one of us, couples and handmaids alike. We have a God that is never, ever, that will never, ever stop. That's why we need to be humble. Because remember, when we are humble, that's the time that God is more near to us. Because whatever grace we have is not because of what our own capacity, it is because of God's blessing. Grow in personal holiness, in couples for Christ, as well as opportunity to serve and greater commitment to evangelization is a continuous process in our community. That's why, after these brothers and sisters, you are being put up into a group. Because through that personal holiness, we will now journey together. As one household, we will pray, we will have teachings, formations, we will have formations that will allow couples to enrich themselves as husband and wife. Now we have that marriage enrichment retreat, 1, 2, then you'll have your covenant orientation. There will be a lot of teachings, same as the handmaids. Of course, there will be no marriage enrichment retreat for the handmaids. That will be handmaids enrichment retreat. You will have more formation and teachings. And that is us growing together in holiness. In CFC Family Ministry, there will be many opportunities to serve. Like what we do when we are called to serve in church, we will serve. When we are called to serve the poor, we will serve. There are a lot of avenues on how now we will relate and try to exert effort to help others. And lastly, we will develop a greater commitment to evangelization. Why? What you have experienced now cannot be stopped, cannot be contained among yourself. You should now go out and testify and tell them that I have been converted, I have been re-evangelized. The work of God is so great that I need to share it with others. That's why I've mentioned you have been evangelized and now you'll become the evangelizer. You will be surprised because words will just come out in your mouth, not even thinking that you're already is sharing God's love. By your actuation, it is already a testimony that God is working in you. And that is by no means of your intent. It just comes out naturally. We build strong Christian families and homes. As mentioned last week, shared by Brother William, no, humanity passes by the way of the family. If the family is not Christ-centered, the society will always be in jeopardy. If the society is Christ-centered, you will see peace, you will see love. There will be no hate. Because Christ is in the center of that community already. From a family to a greater number of people sharing God's love. So these are parts of the ministry. Kids for Christ, no? There will be a lot of activities for kids. You will have sports fest. We will try to share the talents of your children through Kids Got Talent. We know the school here, no, does not allow us some time to really interact and see the talents of our children. Then we will have their formation, their entry level, junior kids day, senior kids day. Then they can also work with the poor, you know, those aunties and uncles in the home. They also share love. Then we have the Youth for Christ. They are also being taught to pray. I just came from a best weekend. It's a camp for father and son, mother and daughter. And I even posted in Facebook that my eyes are sweating because of the chance to be with my son. No? So I don't want to cry. Huh? Let's go on. Then Singles for Christ, of course, that's the age is between 21 to 40. They have their own formation, activities. They are very talented. Singles for Christ are very talented. No, they led the creatives. No, they worship together, same as what we do. Then, the handmaids of the Lord. No? These are our handmaids. No, they have their own teaching, formation. No, they pray together also. They dance. Every year they will have their the All Women's Conference. Then these are the servants of the Lord. That is cool. Right? This is Brother Rene, our family ministry head. They have also served the home. And this is the Couples for Christ community where you can see young and old alike, no, raising hand, praising God. So we are now almost in the conclusion. in couples for Christ, we can continue our transformation in Christ. No? We can also work for the poor. We have this ministry called Answering the Cry of the Poor, where we help not only in their spiritual need. We have scholars, no, where students are being supported in the Philippines. We have this home visit where we now uplift the emotions of the aunties and the uncles in the home. And we have that global walk which, you know, build dreams, no. The proceeds of this walk, global walk, you know, goes to the sponsorship program for education in the Philippines. And we are world changers. We are world changers. The reason why we have been recognized by the Vatican is because the mere purpose of that we are the frontliners of that battle of faith. And as we have seen the transformation of the blind man, we can say Jesus could have just restored the sight of the blind man by merely saying the words, "Be healed." But he chose to go through a process to effect the healing and transformation. Or you can call the MM. And do you agree that the Lord has chosen you?
Yes.
Have you not anticipated this situation that you will be part of a community? No. Especially the husband and the wife. That will improve your prayer time. That would improve your dialogue or your exchanges in communication with your spouse. Sisters, handmaids of the Lord, have you not thought of that? You will be in the community that is vibrant, that will also help you out, no, in your needs, no, advices, journeying with you, accompaniment in life. This is because of God's word. I myself did not realize, no, by mere accident, when we started this journey, no, when my wife had finally was able to convince me to marry her. At least this is my version, huh? No, we were already 7 years and a half engaged, and maybe she really wanted to get married already. And I'm still, no, I thought I'm still young, so I said no. But I was driving along EDSA, and I don't want her to pull the steering wheel. No? So I said, yes, we will get married. But she planned out everything. No, of course, we planned out. No, we wanted to have a good wedding, everything. And one condition that had been set forth before by my father-in-law is, I will not allow you take my daughter and you just stay in apartment. So you must have your own house when you start, when you are want to start as a family. But I was just a lowly paid government employee. As I mentioned, I only have good looks. And that cannot even translate into money. So she planned out, we were able to get the low cost housing. And finally, after getting married, the key was handed over to us. It was really by design, God's design. Now, when we went to that place, as the music ministry are preparing, we saw that there's so many things that is needed to be fixed in that house. Because it's a low-cost housing, you have to fix the ceiling, you have to extend a bit so it become bigger. So we went out because I want to have someone to fix it. A carpenter, no, no, sa Tagalog, aluwage or carpintero. Because I can do it, but I don't have time because I'm still working. So we went out in the highway and waited for a jeep. But someone passed by. He's my college mate, my co-varsity player in the university. And he offered us a lift. You know? In front of that car where I'm sitting and my wife is beside me, I saw a logo. This logo. And I asked him, "Pre," because... actually, he's my close friend, but I think he selected my wife to become the godmother of the son because she's richer than me. That's why. That's why he's my close friend, but she chose my wife. Anyway, what's that logo? And say, "Oh, that's Couples for Christ. Never mind, I will invite you one time." So that invitation came. And I realized that in talk number two, that carpenter that I'm looking for is not the carpenter that will fix my house, but Jesus Christ, who is the carpenter that will fix my home. Amen. And that will happen to you, brothers and sisters. Maybe you have not realized that what kept you going is something that had touched your lives. It is not just by association. It is not just by acquaintance. Because definitely, God had already touched you and already holding you by the hands. So let us rejoice and be glad. Amen?
Amen.
So now, that's the first part. So we spent a little bit of 30 minutes. Now we will spend about an hour. No, this is short. This will be a short process. Later on, I will ask the music ministry to sing a song. And then, I will request the handmaids to stand up, and you will read your covenant. You will have to read your covenant aloud. You will not whisper it because this is your covenant with God. This is not your covenant with Couples for Christ. Whatever you will say in that covenant is what you will do because that is what you have promised God. That is your agreement with God. And after that, I will ask you, the handmaids will sit down. I will also flash it in the screen. The handmaids will sit down and then I will invite the couples to stand and do the same. After that, I will then ask you to sit down. Our music ministry again will play a song. And I will ask you to close your eyes. You close your eyes, you sit relaxed, and open up your hands. And I will pray over you. We will do this dedication so that you will be able to really commit yourself to God. You will promise God, that you will do this as your agreement with Him. So, I invite now our music ministry. So, just relax, recite or declare your covenant for the handmaids of the Lord. Amen. Sisters, you can sit down for a while. So at this part, I would like to invite our couples to stand up. As we declare, I invite the rest of our brothers and sisters as well to read out our covenant with our Lord. Trusting the Lord's help and guidance, I shall live as a follower of Christ. Pray daily for at least 15 minutes. Read scriptures daily for at least 15 minutes. Participate regular worship of my church. Avoid sin and wrongdoing. good God, eternal God, I dedicate myself to the task of building a strong family for Christ. Seek regular weekly dialogue with my spouse, my children. Exercise my duties actively as a parent. Pray with my family. Celebrate the Lord's Day together. Invest generous amount of time for home and family. I will make myself available to the Lord and service. Bring other couples to Christ. Make time to serve couples for Christ. Whenever I am called to service and follow the direction of those who have made responsibility for my service.
I will relate in love and loyalty to other families and couples for Christ.
Attend my small group meetings weekly and support the good order of the meeting. Faithfully attend other meetings. Accept other couples whom the Lord adds to our number. I shall stand
a Christian
person
and understanding and fulfillment of my marriage vocation.
Attend all courses, retreats,
workshops, and conferences of
couples for Christ. Diligently study all the materials given to me. May the Lord Jesus Christ help me to be my net of couples for Christ every day
for His greater honor, glory, and for the good of my brothers and sisters.
Amen. You may sit now, brothers and sisters. As I mentioned, brothers and sisters, that this covenant is not your covenant to couples for Christ, but your covenant to the Lord. You will have that covenant with you. Once we do our Lord's Day celebration, you will receive it. You will sign it because an agreement must be signed. And that covenant will be observed as you have promised God. At this very moment, brothers and sisters, I would like to ask you to relax. Just sit comfortably. And I will seek you to close your eyes. As we are being led by the service, the music ministry, to sing as we call upon the Holy Spirit. And then I will pray over you. As this journey is just a beginning of a greater journey with the community, as a family, as a brothers and as brothers and sisters in Christ. Let us sign ourselves in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Eternal Father, our God Almighty, as we conclude this Christian life program, allow us to lift up to you the faith journey of our new members. Allow us to lift to you up their heart's desires. For several weeks, you have held us by their hand and guided us and guided them as well to realize how much you have loved us. You never gave up on us, and you have sent angels upon angels to tell us how much you love us. You have called us by name, O dear Father, each one of us, and you have softened our hardened heart to allow us to realize that there is nothing that we can do without you, our Lord, our guide and our Savior. We are still a work in progress, O Lord. A work in progress when it comes to our faith journey. But we are already assured that your constant love for us will keep us going. We may falter at times, O God, but your redeeming love will be our foundation to pick ourselves up. We will continue that path to holiness, O Lord, following Jesus each and every day of our lives. You have chosen us and touched us in every aspect of our lives. We can only respond to that call of love and obedience by saying yes, yes to you, O Lord. You have touched us and called us by name, and truly you have chosen us, Lord. You have allowed us to understand how much love you have given for us, Lord. And truly have used our brothers and sisters in this community, Corpus for Christ, to allow us to know that we are part of your flock. We ask our dearly beloved Mother Mary, all the angels and saints, to continue to pray for us as we are now being renewed with that love of Christ. We know that we should hold tight as we need to journey to a much, much greater journey of faith. Lord Jesus, allow us to always be inspired by your love. Allow us to always see Jesus in each and every person that we will encounter. Allow us to share that love to others. The love that cannot be contained in our heart must be proclaimed. As we have been evangelized, we will now be an evangelizer. All of this, we pray in the name of your Son, Jesus, together with the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.